In the day's other news, stocks plunged early on worries about the Russian incursion into eastern Ukraine. They recovered partially, but major indexes still lost 1% or more. The Dow Jones Industrial Average fell 482 points to close at 33,596. The Nasdaq shed 166 points. The S&P 500 slid 44 and is officially in a correction, down more than 10% from its all-time high in January. In Georgia, three white men convicted of murdering a black man, Ahmaud Arbery, in 2020, were found guilty today of federal hate crimes. The jury concluded that Greg and Travis McMichael and their neighbor, William Bryan, targeted and shot Arbery because he was black. In Washington, U.S. Attorney General Merrick Garland welcomed the verdict, but said it goes only so far.
The only acceptable outcome in this matter would have been Mr. Arbery returning safely to his loved ones 2 years ago. His family and his friends should be preparing to celebrate his 28th birthday later this spring, not mourning the second anniversary of his death tomorrow.
We'll return to this verdict after the news summary. The federal civil rights trial stemming from George Floyd's death wound wound down today in St. Paul, Minnesota. Three former police officers are charged with violating his rights. In closing arguments, prosecutors charged that they chose to do nothing as Floyd lay pinned and pleading to breathe. Defense attorneys said that it was a tragedy, but not criminal, and that the men were victims of poor training. The U.S. Supreme Court has agreed to hear a new case involving religion and the rights of LGBTQ people. It involves a Colorado website designer who cited her religious beliefs in refusing to work with same-sex couples. She challenged a state anti-discrimination law, but a lower court found that it did not violate her First Amendment rights. On the pandemic, Hong Kong today ordered compulsory COVID testing for its entire population starting in mid-March. It's driven by an Omicron surge that threatens to overwhelm healthcare services. Under the order, Hong Kong's 7.5 million people have to be tested three times over 7 days. But on the streets today, there were doubts.
I don't think that the government is prepared to do the universal testing. It is such a waste of time. I think the government should consider increasing the hospital manpower and facilities to better support the health workers.
Since the year began, the densely populated city has reported nearly 54,000 cases and 145 deaths. Researchers project nearly 100 deaths a day by late March. And back in this country, the U.S. women's national soccer team has reached an equal pay settlement with the U.S. Soccer Federation. In all, 28 players will split $22 million in damages. Another $2 million will benefit retired players and aid in boosting the sport. The Federation also committed to equalizing future pay for women. They have received far less than the men, despite winning four World Cups since 1985. Still to come on the News Hour, Homeland Security Secretary Mayorkas discusses possible Russian cyber attacks and challenges at the border. The U.S. women's soccer team wins that multi-million-dollar settlement in the fight for equal pay. Multiple cyclones and a historic drought cause widespread food insecurity in Madagascar, plus much more.
This is the PBS News Hour. From WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West, from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.